The Philippine Coast Guard flags the prolonged stay of Chinese militia vessels in the West Philippine Sea. The Coast Guard says over 100 vessels from Beijing are still in the Julian Felipe Reef a week after they were spotted in the area. It also said two Chinese Coast Guard vessels were seen in the Ayungin Shoal in its latest monitoring. The shoal, located 100 nautical miles off Palawan Province, was the site of a tense face-off between Manila and Beijing's Coast Guard ships that caused a near collision on April 23rd. Philippine Senator Robin Padilla says press freedom remains under threat by disinformation. Padilla, who chairs the Senate Committee on Public Information and Mass Media, is calling on his fellow lawmakers in the upper chamber to formulate laws which will curb the spread of fake news. He also emphasized the importance of respecting the freedom of the press.
The second batch of Filipinos rescued from Sudan now back home in the Philippines. More on that story from our correspondent Jose Carretero, who joins us on the line. Jose?
Yes, Ron, the second batch of repatriated Filipino Islamic students in Sudan have arrived past 12 noon today at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Terminal 1. Along with the students was an overseas Filipino worker couple with their three children and another male OFW. The couple declined an oncoming interview, saying they are still in trauma, especially their children who are aged 12 and 13. The president of the Filipino student studying at the International University of Africa in Sudan, Norhad Ananaid Langiles, said it took them 4 days before they were able to escape Khartoum. During the first day of the conflict, he said most of them are unaware of what was happening as their neighbor only told them the commotion was just a part of military exercises. There were 117 Filipino students in Sudan, according to Langiles. He said all of them were traumatized. The first batch of 31 students arrived last night. Another batch is scheduled to arrive in the coming days, according to Langiles. After the trauma they went through, they are now thankful they are safely back in the Philippines. Langiles said the Philippine government had promised to help them find another international school so they could still continue their studies. Meanwhile, another batch of OFWs is expected to arrive tonight, according to Department of Migrant Workers Assistant Secretary Venny Legaspi. 17 OFWs are expected to arrive tonight at the NAIA Terminal 1. There are 750 registered Filipinos in Sudan, according to DFA. Ron?
Jose Carretero with that update. Thanks for that.
A total of 100,000 people from Sudan have now crossed to neighboring countries to escape the conflict. Hundreds of thousands more have been displaced by the ongoing fighting. With a number of evacuees still expected to rise, the United Nations aid chief will visit Sudan to try to improve humanitarian access through guarantees of safe passage.
At least 334,000 people have been internally displaced within Sudan as a result of the fighting the 15th of April, according to IOM's Displacement Tracking Matrix Network report, which was released last night and has been disseminated to media here in Geneva. The number of displaced people through the last 2 weeks exceeds, as a result of conflict, exceeds all conflict-related displacements reported in Sudan in 2022.